The world's largest coral reef is in danger. Now a UN assessment begins. Hello, I'm Rob, and this is News Review from BBC Learning English. And to talk about this story with me is Roy. Hello, Roy.
Hello, Rob, and hello, everybody. If you would like to test yourself on the vocabulary around this story, all you need to do is head to our website, bbclearningenglish.com, to take a quiz. But now let's hear more about this story from this BBC News report.
The United Nations delegation is beginning an assessment of the state of the world's largest coral reef off the western coast of Australia. The UN last year recommended the Great Barrier Reef be added to the World Heritage Committee's in danger list because of damage caused by climate change. The Australian government lobbied against such a move, but Dr. Jodie Rummer from James Cook University in Queensland says it may be what's needed to highlight the danger the reef faces.
So, this story is about the Great Barrier Reef, which is the world's largest barrier reef and is located in Australia. Some scientists say that it is under threat from the effects of climate change. A UN delegation is going to assess the barrier reef's health. It wants to assess whether its World Heritage status should be changed to in danger.
And we've got three words and expressions from the news headlines about this story. What are they, please?
We have in danger, ways, and dire.
That's in danger, ways, and dire. OK, well, let's pick the first word from your first headline. What is it, please?
OK, so the first headline is from RTE, and it reads: UN considers listing Great Barrier Reef as in danger.
That's in danger, at risk.
Yeah, okay, so this is two words. First word in, I-N, second word danger, D-A-N-G-E-R. And it basically means the possibility of harm to someone or something, or even death.
Hmm. And I noticed that we add the preposition in, not at or on danger.
Yeah, we commonly use it with in danger to say that something is at risk or under threat.
Hmm. And we said in danger, not endangered. There's a difference there, isn't there?
Yes, there is. So in danger, I-N-D-A-N-G-E-R, the two words, basically means you're at risk of harm or death, potentially. You're in a dangerous situation. So, for example, maybe it's late at night and I'm worried, I'm a little bit scared. So I call my wife to come and pick me up from the area because I feel that I am in danger. In other words, I am at risk of harm. Endangered, which is E-N-D-A-N-G-E-R-E-D, we usually use it to talk about an animal or a plant that is at risk of going extinct, existing no more. So there are many endangered species in the world.
Okay, I got it. Endangered is about extinction, wildlife becoming extinct. In danger is about a risk to your safety, I guess.
Absolutely.
And I mean, danger is a serious thing. Being in danger is very serious. Do we always use this expression in a kind of serious context?
Well, we can also use it informally to also mean at risk. So, for example, if you're a football fan and you're watching your football team, they're not playing very well, you could say the team is in danger of losing the match. So at risk there.
OK, well, we're in danger of running out of time, so let's get on with a summary. We've talked about the Great Barrier Reef on News Review before. It's always been in danger. How can we watch this video again, please, Roy?
All you need to do is click the link in the description below.
Just down there below. Fantastic. Okay, let's have a look at your next news headline, please.
Okay, so our next headline comes from Channel News Asia, and it reads: UN weighs listing Great Barrier Reef as in danger.
So that's ways, K carefully considers facts in order to make a decision.
Okay, so weighs is spelled W-E-I-G-H-S, and it is a verb. And it basically means to consider something or think about something very deeply and carefully.
And I'm familiar with this word weighs and the word weight. It's to do with measuring the heaviness of something. So you put things on a scale, maybe, or some scales, and you measure how heavy something is. That's weighing, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's sort of connected. Okay, so for example, when you're talking about the physical weight, as you say, you're putting an object onto some scales or a machine to measure how heavy something is. And we commonly talk about things like kilos, kilograms, grams, stones. In British English, we talk about stones and pounds. Some people use those measurements to talk about the physical heaviness. Now, weighs in the headline is actually talking about taking all of the information and the facts and considering what they mean, considering what that information means. It's weigh up the information. And notice there I said weigh up. We commonly use a phrasal verb, weigh something up or weigh up something. So to give you an example of that, recently we talked about your phone. You have a terrible phone. It was broken. I think you said one of the buttons, the letters didn't work. And I kept telling you to buy a new phone. And in the end I said, look, just think about all the positives and the negatives. Weigh up the pros and the cons.
Yeah, and that's what I did. I weighed up all my options and chose a brand new shiny phone. Thank you for that, Roy.
You're welcome.
And also, when I go into the cake shop, because I love cakes, I like to weigh up my options there. I look at all those delicious pastries, which one to choose. I often choose the one that is going to make me put on more weight. That's the noun, weight, more heaviness.
Yes. W-E-I-G-H-T, weight, the noun.
Indeed. Thank you. Let's have a summary. So we've been talking about the word weight, and we did a program about the expression punch above your weight. The program is called The English We Speak. And how can we watch it again, Roy?
All you need to do is click the link in the description below.
Okay, let's have a look at your next headline, please.
Okay, so our next headline comes from the Climate Council website, and it reads, dire warning for Great Barrier Reef as UN inspection begins. Climate Council briefing.
That's dire, extremely serious.
Yes, so this word is dire and it is spelt D-I-R-E. And it basically is an adjective and it used to describe something that is very bad or very serious.
So, and we use the word dire to talk about bad situations.
Yes, so we commonly use it to talk about situations or conditions. So for example, if somebody is living in a house with no heating, no water, no electricity, that we could say that they are living in dire conditions, very serious or bad conditions. Another way that we use the word dire, though, and it's slightly different, is in front of the word need, in dire need of something. And it means when we are desperate or really, really need something. So, for example, in the morning, I maybe wake up, I'm really tired, and I'm very dramatic. I say, I'm in dire need of a coffee.
You are desperate for coffee. I know that feeling. And what about the expression in dire straits? I've heard about that as well.
Okay, so yeah, in dire straits, we sometimes use this and it talks about very serious or terrible situation. And we commonly use this to talk about money, a lack of money. So for example, at the end of the month, just before you get paid again, maybe you've spent all of your money and you have no money to do anything or to buy food, you could say that you are in dire straits. It's talking about a very serious situation with a lack of money in that case.
Yeah, an extreme situation, dire straits. Okay, let's have a summary. Okay, Roy, it's time now for you to recap the words and expressions that we've talked about today, please.
Okay, so we had in danger, at risk. Weighs. Carefully considers facts in order to make a decision. And we had dire. Extremely serious.
Now, if you want to test your understanding of today's words and expressions, we have a quiz on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. And that's the place to go to for lots of other learning English resources. So check it out. Oh, and don't forget, we're all over social media as well. Okay, well, that's all for today's news review. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now. Bye-bye.
Bye.